Hi, welcome to Central News for Friday the 11th of November. I'm Katrina McKinley. In today's news, the message from Tourism Bay of Plenty in relation to the Rena disaster is the bay is open for business with pristine beaches waiting for people to keep their summer traditions.
I guess we're endeavouring to look at things in a positive way. We've seen the impact, we've seen people's businesses being really affected by what happens, and the negative media has been the worst thing we're having to face. Headlines that suggest the place is closed, the port's closed to tourists, to cruise ships. It's been that perception when you walk down here and look at these pristine beaches and you've got people still showing photographs of oil all over the beaches. That's been the hardest thing to counter.
U Drive has struck a chord with Otamoitai College students by making the study process for a learner's licence easier and more comprehensible. Otamoitai College student Dana Hampson says the AMS Group's U Drive program makes getting your learners easy with only being in class for 2 days, opposed to studying the road code.
I feel that it helped me learn everything I needed to know about getting my learner's licence instead of having to read the road code and doing all the studying that no one wants to do. And then it just teaches you everything you need to know in the course.
A year after the soil was first turned, our village garden, Te Kete o Te Aroha, will officially open to the public on Sunday from 1 o'clock at the community garden site in Rewi Street next to the Te Aroha police station. And everyone is welcome. Garden coordinator Josie Ashworth says now that they are established, they would love more people to come along, join them in the garden and learn how to grow their own food. There will be a booth at the opening where people can sign up for a free garden plot, be teamed with an experienced gardener to get started and eventually take home the food they grow. Time to check out the region's weather, and it has been a super sunny Friday for both regions, but the good weather looks set to ease off tomorrow. Tauranga, you are heading for a high of 21 and a low of 10. In Hamilton, we'll have a high of 18 and a chilly low of 6. There are cloudy periods and light winds in store for both cities, with sea breezes in Tauranga and possible evening showers in Hamilton. Our long-range weather forecaster Ken Ring says across the Waikato Bay of Plenty region, it should be dry until midweek, followed by showers off and on for the following 8 days, with some potentially heavier showers northwesterlies. Allow 1 to 2 days error in all forecasts. For more information, go to his website, predictweather.co.nz. Coming up after the break, we have the latest from the Wallace Gallery in Morrinsville, and to do with My Tag, My Town. TV Rotorua brings us an update on the Biological Farming Systems Conference, and the Ambassador for the Head Injury Awareness Network for Kiwis, Elizabeth Charleston, talks about the effects of a head injury. Join me and the team after the break.